Welcome to today's Maitri Milan section. Let us start the section with three rounds of Omkara.
Yeah.
Meaning, the Lord spoke, I shall now briefly describe my divine glories to you, O West of the Kurus, for there is no end to their detail.
Sri Gurubhyo Namaha, Suprabhatam. So far we have seen Bhagavan introduced himself as the material cause of the world and said, those who can see me in everything, everywhere, all time. Means what? It's not that every time you have the thought of that only. What it means is that the back of the mind, when you see something, at the back of the mind, the knowledge is Bhagavan is everywhere. That person will be ready to get the knowledge of my highest nature, original consciousness, which is also every individual's original nature, the pure consciousness, and they get moksha. So now Arjuna wants to know how to meditate upon Vishwarupa Ishvara. Why meditate? Because only when you practice that meditation, you train the mind, and slowly, spontaneously, at the back of the mind, whenever you do any interaction, any transaction, you know that only Bhagavan is there. Therefore, Arjuna is asking Krishna Bhagavan that please give me certain alambana. We have seen that. What is alambana? Please give me certain glories in the form of alambana, support, so that I can meditate upon Vishwarupa Ishvara. Ishvara in the form of the entire world. So therefore now Bhagavan is going to answer his question. So let us look at this verse. Shri Bhagavanu Bhagavan Uvacha Hanta Te Katayishyami Divyaha Hi Atma Vibhutaya Pradhanyataha Kurushreshta Na Asti Antaha Vistarasya me. So Bhagavan now is telling, he is giving introduction to his answer. He is going to respond a little elaborately. The entire chapter is about his response after this shloka. But he is giving introduction. The introduction is, well, you have asked for this, so I am going to talk about my glories. So Hanta, well, te to you, kathayishyami, I will be talking about. Okay, divyaha atma vibhutayaha. He indeed, divyaha atma vibhutayaha. Divyaha means extraordinary, atma vibhutayaha. Atma vibhuta, atma here means oneself. Bhagavan says, my vibhuti, my glory. Why extraordinary glory? That also we have discussed in alambana. When you want to meditate, you take something that is extraordinary. Not normal mountain, you take something that is Mount Kailash. When you see Mount Kailash, oh God, that awness, that wonderstruckness comes. That means that automatically invokes something is extraordinary about it. So God's presence is automatically coming in your head. Therefore, extraordinary glories. There are ordinary glories also. Glories are there. What is ordinary glory? What we see every day. You know your eyes wink. All of you know your eyes wink. Do you know why your eyes wink? No. Your eyes wink because there is an automatic mechanism. Your eyes should not dry. The eyeballs should not be kept dry. So your eyes wink, therefore it gets lubricated with the water. There are many people who suffer from this dry eye. They need to have this lotion. So you can see, even in ordinary winking of an eye, there is an order. Otherwise it will not work and there will be problem. Ask people who are not able to wink their eye or the eyes is dry. They have to constantly have a solution and apply. So even in ordinary places, you can appreciate Bhagavan. But that does not happen because we see it every day, we take it for granted. Even our parents' love, we take it for granted because they give everything and every day you get without asking, you take it for granted. So whatever we get without asking or we see regularly, we take it for granted. Therefore, Bhagavan is saying, I will talk about my extraordinary glories. Divyaha Atma Vibhutayaha. But he also says, Na Asti Antaha Vistarasya. If you want me to elaborate, even extraordinary glories do not have any end. Because it's not glory about this world, it is glory about 14 lokas. There are 14 lokas, 14 lokas above, 14 lokas below. Then there is glory every kalpa. You do panchanga reading, so you know there are kalpas. So every kalpa there will be glory. So there is no end. It is limitless. even to extraordinary glory there is limit, there is no limit. Therefore he says there is no limit even to my extraordinary glories. Therefore hey Kuru Shrestha, why he says Kuru Shrestha? There is a reason. Kuru Naam Shrestha, Shrestha means the one who is very very good or the best among the Kuru. Kuru is the Kaurav Vamsha which is there, they are Kuru Vamsha basically. So Shrestha, so he is telling, why is he telling Kuru Naam Shrestha? He is telling to indicate that you are also my vibhuti, extraordinary vibhuti. Okay, so that is what he is trying to say. That is why Kuru Shrestha Pradhanyatah. So he says I will not be able to elaborate everything. So Pradhanyatah, there are certain important extraordinary glories which I will be talking about from now on. So that is this shloka. So from this shloka we learn that we are supposed to look, when we look at extraordinary things, we look at awe, then immediately what comes to us or what strikes us is Bhagavan. And this should be the case every time. So this is how you start slowly developing what is called as Vishwarupa Darshanam. You see Bhagavan as the entire world. Bhagavan alone is manifesting as this entire world. Thank you.
Good morning. So all of us already aware that 21st June is the International Day of Yoga. It is our function, but whole world is celebrating very enthusiastically. So we have to celebrate with double enthusiasm, isn't it? So we also organize that function. Just I inform you, the function will be starting by 7 a.m. The protocol practice. So 6:45, all of you should assemble in front of Tarangini. Stage will be set just in front of Om building. Just in front of the stage, all BNY students, yoga students and YAC students has to take the place. Just behind them, the nursing students. Just behind them, the Ayurveda students. Left side of the stage, that is in front of Dean's office, all our faculty should assemble. Since it's a yoga day, so attendance is mandatory for all the students and faculty on that day. 8 to 8:30, stage function will be there. So we'll be having the popular guests in the queue. We'll be finalizing today. 8:30, we will have a special breakfast that day for all of you who are all participating. Okay. So if rain comes, the rain is also forecasting here. So if rain comes, what happens? Don't think, transform that enthusiasm to sleep, to continue in the beds. Okay, we have a plan B for that. If at all rain comes, in Shruti Bhavan, all naturopathy, yoga and YAC students will practice. If place is not enough, then YAC students will practice in Mangal Mandir. In Sanskriti Bhavan, Ayurveda and nursing students will be participating. 8 to 8:30, stage function will be here in the Shruti Bhavan only. After finishing your the protocol, all of you join back. This is the plan. Okay? So don't think function is cancelled and continuously. Got it? Thank you. I request Prashant ji to hoist the flag. Announcement is there.
I would like to call Lehit from PNYS to make an announcement.
Good morning everyone. From 14th of June to 16th of June, a group of 80 plus students from BNYS had taken part in the competition called as Synapse. Synapse was an inter-college sports and cultural extravaganza which was hosted by Government Vellore Medical College, Tamil Nadu. It brings me immense happiness to say that many of us have bagged many prizes. I would like to call upon the sports secretary to announce sports winners. The certificates and the medals will be given in the coming week.
Namaste everyone. I would like to announce the winners of the sports events in which we have got the 1 gold, 1 silver, and 10 bronze medals. First of all, in the short put event, Vedika Shri from first year won the gold medal. Please have a big round of applause. second in the athletic events 200 meter sprint. Gauri from first year secured the silver medal. Coming back to the field events, that is discus throw, Vedika Shri again from first year have secured the bronze medal. Field events boys javelin throw, Pramod from first year have secured the bronze medal. Coming to the athletic events boys and girls, 100 into 4, that is a baton relay, boys have secured the bronze medal, that is Yogeshwaran, Pramod, Omkar and Varad. 100 into 4 relay, baton relay, girls, they have secured the bronze medal, Sanchita, Sri Darshini, Gauri and Pratiksha.
For the cultural event, we were divided into various categories such as singing, dancing, face painting, fireless cooking, picto and many more. The winners are, second prize goes for Pictionary event, the winners Swati and Basumati from fourth year. Adzap competition, first prize goes to Leher, Kavya, Preksha, Basumati. For the shipwreck competition, the first prize goes to Vaishnavi S from first year. For fireless cooking, the first prize goes to Purnashri and Sinchana from BNYS third year. Adaption, second prize goes to Sanchita from fourth year. For Choreo Night, special mention for Rutambara from first year. For Mandala Art, second position goes to Aishwarya Rathod from second year. For face painting, second position goes to Purnima and Pavitra from third year. For connections, first prize goes to Kamal, Jaya, Balaji and Basumati. For Damsharats, third position goes to Kamal, Jaya, Balaji and Preksha again. For solo dance, we had got the special mention for Adi Rai from second year. For K-drama quiz, second prize goes to Shreya, Swati and Aishwarya from second and fourth year. Congratulations to all the winners and the participants. I also would like to thank our respected principal, Dr. Apar Sauji, for encouraging and sending the group of students to showcase our talents. And also a huge thanks to Dr. Divya for taking care of us and accompanying us along. Thank you. I would like to call Prashant sir for flag hoisting. Let us conclude the section with Shanti Mantra.
Om Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah, Sarve Santu Niramayah, Sarve Bhadrani Pashyantu, Ma Kashchit Dukha Bhavet. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.
वंदे।